There we go.
So just to check, it's not going to pop up ads during the stream.
When you first log in, you might, but it's only one ad now.
It's only one ad.
You in the room?
Yeah.
Go down below me and mute the room.
Is that better?
Yeah, there we go. Alright, let's see. Check everything here. That's good. Alright, guys, can you see us and hear us? Are we alright, or? Alright, good. Are you freaking kidding me? Who's at the door? Alright, we're good? We're good.
Sorry.
Alright, guys. Who all videos sensing good? Good?
Some trick dance coming over.
Who? Oh.
Trick guys walking.
Oh, okay. Alright, well, who all we got in here today? Alright, how do you pronounce it? Just grammar, or?
Correct.
Okay. The guys that's in here, I'd like to come delegate Grammar in today from Maryland, which is actually most of the so far. We actually worked together last night for some questions from you. Almost all they are Maryland.
Excellent.
So this was like a really, really big deal for them, especially. So. All right. No, she. You see her yet? Our lad. Yeah, there you go. Rob, this is my wife, Colleen. She's the other owner of our juice line. So.
How you doing?
I'm good. I'm gonna kind of pop in and out a little bit, so that way we're not two people on camera. And then we have our friend here, who does tricks for us, so we sponsor. And he's sitting on the other side of, so I don't know if he gets the camera angled just right, he might be able to get Cody in the picture, yeah. Too. So you slide over this way, and then Cody can slide in.
But, and then you alright. Issues with keyboards, etc. So,
I'll come in on my phone.
And yeah, you guys
trying to see me here.
Hold yeah, that's Cody. That's our trick guy. So we sponsor.
How you doing?
I'm doing all right.
First off, I know you just over there in Maryland got that tax law denied.
Yeah, you know, for something as common sense as you would think that leaders and lawmakers would want to promote vaping. You know, for 50 years, we've been looking for a way for people to kick the habit of smoking. And now, you know, people are vapers, not only because it's a cool habit, because they want to kick the what many feel is the addiction of tobacco. But there's just a lot of people that see this as a source of revenue. They want to tax the hell out of it. They want to regulate the way that they want to ban it everywhere. And you know, there's only people like me that see the value in it, but and, you know, we'll do everything we can to protect the rights of vapers across the country.
Oh man, that one hit hard. One of our other, I thought I read someone as well, so that got in here with our conversation like questions for you. That's one of their questions. Was a vapor, so and that one also. So,
and I will say, I do have like a little IDP, you know, places you could do. There's certain places you can't hit people. I'm more of a coffee guy. If I smoke, I typically smoke cigars. Occasion you're around people, you just want to be cool and you know, you'll smoke some slight on my MVP. So
okay, yeah, that sounds like Rogue. Try refreshing your room. It may just be the last. Okay, you got it. Okay, yeah, it may just be the lag in it. So, but yeah, I don't know. Like, you know, we're going through a lot. They're trying to pretty much monopolize over here on it. So,
and mainly the issue that we have right now is there's only one company. And in Lafayette, and that's Mall House, yeah, that can meet the security regulations for this.
Yeah.
And that's the main issue that we're having is there's just this singular company, and it's the only one right now that can do it, and they don't have the manpower even, you know, as far as the staff to even get to all of these different buildings, especially across the state of Indiana.
Yeah.
And that's going to be another issue is getting put on hold because they have to hire, you know, techs and things like that.
All right.
That's making permits even harder to get through to begin with, just because that they get up on the manpower, which is just going to cost even more money, more waiting time, more people are going to get put behind. You know, right. And if these guys can get in par with it, you know, in time, it's going to end up shutting down these little companies just because, you know, with the lack of the kind of the export that we get in Indiana, this law is going to affect, you know, it's not just going to affect, you know, the Indiana, you know, business owners, but it's also going to affect, you know, the export, you know, that comes out of California, out of, you know, just in any of our surrounding states. It's also going to affect that because, you know, the bill also, you know, kind of knocks them out of it too.
And so that's are these businesses producers of vape products or the juice? Or
yeah, any juice company. What the law is basically saying is you have to get a permit, even if you're out of state. Say you're the shop in Lafayette that carries our line. They're carrying other lines, say, from California or whatever state they're from. They actually have to get a Indiana manufacturing permit, which costs $1,000, and also then it's like, I know the one guy that was on last week, Hoosier Vapors, it's going to cost him $20,000 just for the security, the cameras and stuff that they're requiring. It's going to cost him over $20,000. And then there's only one certain company. And the thing is, that company, you've had to been there for a long time to be qualified to do this job on the vape shops and the e-juice. You can't just go out, hire, say, Joe Blurrow, and him be qualified to do it. They're not on that.
Yeah, so there are a lot of lobbies and a lot of interest groups. What they'll do to cut out the competition is they'll put either procurement or regulatory permitting laws in place that make it so prohibitive that it basically precludes any small business from getting access into the market.
Yeah.
And I mean, the permitting is fairly open, so you have a lot of businesses. There's no monopolies. There's no big guy crowding out the competition. So to me, it sounds like you really need to get an ad legislature to say, hey, this isn't the way we should be doing things. We should give the little guy access to the market.
Yeah, because with that one company that there is going to monopolize to cover every juice maker, every vape shop, every anything that's got to do with e-juice, one security company to cover all of them, it's pretty much, it's going to shut everybody down.
Right, right.
So another thing that I had kind of noticed was reading through these bills, you know, it doesn't really hit on, you know, tobacco corporation e-cigs. You know, you have your Mark 10 e-cigs, which are Philip Morris, Boost, which are basically Camel. But it doesn't really touch, you know, even though that those have a type of e-juice in or an e-gel, if you broke one apart. But the regulatory, you know, things that are going against these e-juice companies don't apply to these companies because they're considered, you know, a cig-alike, which is part of the big tobacco industry.
Right, right. So let me get this straight. The big corporations are getting carve-outs so they can have access to the market, but you can't. Is that right?
Yes.
That's how corporate interest works in a lot of places.
Yeah.
And you'll see this in every state. You'll see Maryland. It's the big guys. They're looking to kill the little guy. They're looking to cut out the little guy. And it's not the way it should be done. You know, setting up a store selling vapes and juice, that's something any small business owner can do right in his community.
Mm-hmm.
And like I said, you really got to get an advocate in the legislature to stand up for you and say, look, this is wrong.
Right.
Yeah. And our biggest thing is everyone we've seen has denied the any restructure of the law, everybody's denying it. So that's why Evan from Hoosier Vapors Advocacy Group that was on last week, he's actually fighting it, and he's actually got a lawsuit against the state of Indiana right now. So
I think it's actually a couple of companies that have
So lawsuits are a good way to speak up and speak up against laws that are bad. Really, I think what the vaping community needs to do, and that they haven't really recognized yet, is become your own lobby. I mean, the vaping community is huge, and it's a cross section of every culture, every, you know, racial group. There are a lot of people that vapes, and it's, you know, 5 to 10% of the population. And when lawmakers start to realize that, and the vaping community speaks up for itself, there's really not going to be a way to deny it, but what the vaping community hasn't done yet is it hasn't organized and come together as one voice, and I think that's what you need to do.
Yeah, I know when I shared the, because we got till May, I believe it is, first to file to re-edit the law or be able to get changed. I know I've come across quite a few just because they're not in Indiana. I shared that link where they signed the petition and right. They've denied to sign it because they don't live in Indiana. But if you notice, Indiana started on the e-cigs and then Arkansas and then Cal. I mean, they're all following suit of Indiana.
Right.
Part of my question to you, maybe you could help me, you know, better understand this, is I know you had mentioned about, you know, us kind of becoming our own lobby, and that there's quite a few of us out here. There's, you know, just you know, within the Lafayette, Kokomo, you know, Monticello areas, you know, even as well as Flora. But how can we, as, you know, a group of vapors that don't necessarily have a lot of money to put into lobbying, you know, what do you recommend that we could potentially do to come together and kind of, you know, let our voice be heard, just because we don't all necessarily have the money to put into lobbying, to put into a bunch of stuff to actually get to, you know, the bigger fish in the sea?
Well, I think the thing that should make you guys hopeful is that effective lobbying doesn't always need a lot of money. You do need a lot of voices. I think it starts with a good bill, good language, really having a single advocate in your legislature who will say, you know, this is the law, this is how it should be, and this is going to be the bill that gets us there. And then really rallying your people behind that bill, whether you have to get, you know, the vaping community down in your state capital, or you need to rally them to get other legislators behind the bill. I don't think you need a whole lot of money, but you need to start having your people speak up collectively and say this is direction we want to go, and get a vote on the bill, and hold your elected officials accountable.
What I know, I've been searching, which he was on one of the other shows a few weeks ago. Larry Faircloth from West Virginia also vapes, and he got the bill vetoed for taxes in West Virginia. I know he's searching, and as far as I know, he hadn't come across anybody. How do I go about finding the delegates that are for the vaping community and getting somebody on our side to speak for us?
You know, I think that's really the social part of working in the legislature is actually the most interesting. And I think if you started with your own legislator, I think that's a good start. Sit down with him. Just say, look, here's our concern. Here's how we feel about it. People think that legislators are all-knowing, ever-present forces in politics, but really, most positive change starts with a good conversation. And, you know, I'd start with your own legislator and sit down with them and say, look, here's our concern. Here's what we want to get done. And, you know, when they start to become more knowledgeable about your issue, they might become your hero. They might be a vapor themselves. I think starting with a good conversation with your own legislator is probably the best place to start. And if that doesn't work, you can, you know, talk to other leaders in your area or in your state and see if they would be interested in taking up the fight for you.
Now, how would you recommend that we get a hold of legislators? Because a lot of them, you know, especially emails, things like that, a lot of them, because of the petitions that are going around, things like that, to bring us together, they're kind of forced into automated emails now. So it's really hard to actually get a hold of the legislator themselves, especially even with phone calls. And the amount of people that are calling them are getting a lot of just automated responses from emails, calls, things of that sort. You know, how would we potentially go about actually successfully getting a hold of one of the legislators?
So, and I'll say this to be fair. If I get a form email and there's 200 of them, there's no way that I can write 200 custom emails. I usually write the response myself and use that because all the emails are identical. But with that said, email isn't always the best way to work something like this. Really, if you're looking for a solution where you really need to sit to come to an understanding about an issue, really on the phone or in person, preferably in person, is the best way to really get to the bottom of the issue here. Maryland's not a huge state, so we afford the opportunity for most people, you know, to drive down to the state capitol, sit down with their legislators. I'm not sure where the state capitol in Indiana is in proximity to everybody else or how far you live from your state capitol. But really, you know, it seems like you guys are really taking the lead on this and you really want to make this happen. So if possible, I'd call up and say, look, I want to schedule 15 minutes with my legislator. Is there any way that we could schedule a time, sit down 15, 30 minutes, talk about this issue, talk about why it's important, and maybe have them look into sponsoring a bill for us? And I think most people are going to be very open to that.
So I know we were talking in our group, like I said, all of us coming up with some questions, which quite a few has already been asked and answered. But there was one that kind of goes with that. On top of it, where was it? Now, voice is heard. Okay, well, actually, that they pretty much all go back to that. So, now we pretty well answered. Anybody else have any questions by chance that you'd like to ask or? Now, do you think if the FDA finds it for unhealthy or whatever, you think that will just pretty well shut the whole thing down in the whole country, or?
So when you get federal regulations, it's really tough because local government, local representatives are very responsive. As your representatives get further and further from the people, it's exceptionally hard to get a response from them. And, you know, when you have something like the FDA, now you're stepping away from your representative into a bureaucracy. The bureaucrats aren't accountable whatsoever. They don't even have to listen to you. They're just going to base whatever regulation they put forward on whatever a study finds. And, I mean, you know, how many times in your life had you heard studies prove, well, this study contradicts another study.
Yeah.
And that's what the FDA is basing pretty much everything they operate on. I'm hoping the FDA generally keeps their hands off of vaping. There's in the back of my mind, there's small parts of me that say, we don't know the long-term impact of vaping. But you know what? I do know the long-term impact of smoking. And like I said before, vaping and the use of e-cigarettes has helped millions of people kick the habit. Before I was a lawmaker, I worked in an office building with several hundred people. For years and years, we'd see people go out on lunch, and there'd be 10 or 20 people smoking cigarettes.
Right.
And you know, over the course of a couple of years, that just stopped because everybody had bought a vape, and everybody was, you know, smoking something fruity or something that tastes like Captain Crunch. And it's really helped people kick the habit. So the federal bureaucracy, that's a hard nut to crack. And for me, I'm generally hoping that the FDA keeps their hands off of the vaping regulation.
Right. Okay, we have a question actually from Astorana. She's one of the ones from Maryland as well. But she said, what can we do for California since we're in Maryland?
So inform me about the California law.
I don't even have that one pulled up. I believe they're trying to do that crazy taxes like Chicago is, but in the whole state, I believe.
I know they got something right. Like being 21 to vape.
And I know they're trying to make it where you got to be 21 to smoke or vape, or there's like a couple different things they're trying to pull.
Yeah, so this is kind of the way democracy works. If you live in Maryland, the state lawmakers in California, frankly, just aren't going to listen to you. I have 125,000 people in my district, and those are predominant. Those are the people that elected me. Those are the people I'm going to listen to.
Right.
So it's very tough, you know, to help. You know, the vaping community wants to help vapers across the country, but it's next to impossible to lobby for people in another state. I think the best thing you could do, no matter what state you're in, is really just build the community in your state and say, look, what's happening in California is nonsensical. This is a product that's helping people. We shouldn't be banning it. We shouldn't be over-regulating it. We shouldn't be taxing the hell out of it. We here in Maryland or Indiana, we need to make sure our lawmakers understand that they need to keep their hands the hell off of these products. So I wish there was an answer for you there, but the people in California are really going to have to stand up to fix California law.
Okay, and then also, which Eddie asked, which pretty much will be the same thing, what can us from out of state do to our support for the fight in Indiana? I mean, they can do that form that I posted to fill it out, but like you said, being from another state doesn't mean they're going to listen to it.
Right. So there's a value in everything you do. If you can't make it to the state capitol, and I fully understand that, nobody has, frankly, a whole day to go lobby in their state capitol, and you might get only 15 minutes with your legislator,
yeah,
if they're available at all. Things like petition drives, I think, are pretty powerful. If you get 20 people, if you get 100 people in your community to sign a petition, that's a pretty strong statement that people are against an increase in taxes on vapes or vape juice or whatever. If you call yourself or you write, you know, just write an email from scratch and say, look, these are my concerns. Like, I read all those personally in my district. So even something as small as that, that small grassroots level organization, I think that's very powerful. Yeah. But I think it really starts with, you know, leaders in the BAPE community coming together and saying, look, this is what we're going to do. This is how we're going to make sure that all our representatives in the state capitol understand that we don't want this.
All right. Okay. And which okay. I remember that now. No, January 10th in California are classifying e-cigs as regular tobacco products, restricting their use in public places.
Yeah, and that's, you know, I wish if I had 3 hours, I could tell you about all the nonsense that I see in Annapolis, which is Maryland State.
Yeah.
It's quite clear that vaporizers and e-cigarettes are not tobacco. Smoke cigars, and frankly, you know, I smoke cigars. I smoke outside. I cannot stand to sit in a room with that's filled with smoke. I mean, it's just something that I can't tolerate. But yeah. With that said, like, we're not talking about e-cigs and vaporizers are much different. It dissipates quickly. You're not sitting in a smoke-filled room. It might be a little annoying, you know, people are going to smell Captain Crunch, but it's radically different than smoking cigarettes.
All right. Which, I mean, now, we're in the position you're in, I hear a lot of this as well. Do you believe that they're aiming e-juice towards kids because it's Crunch Berries or Pixie Sticks or Swedish Fish? Do you believe that when we come out with those flavors, that it's aimed towards kids?
I'm not a marketer. I'm not a e-juice a businessman. But just from my experience, like, the people that I'm around that use vapes a lot are 35 to 40 years old. And they're smoking everything from tobacco flavors to fruit, and I keep mentioning the big one, like the Captain Crunches, and these are 35 and 40 year old people. You know, the I do not see the vape shops in my area selling to children. It's just not happening. So, you know, I could see how young people would be more inclined to smoke something that tastes like Captain Crunch, but predominantly, it's the people that have been smokers for 20 years or more, and they're looking for a more healthy solution. They're looking for a way to kick the habit. They found vapes. It's been successful, and that's why they're smoking what they're smoking.
And to add on to what you say, which I also, as a juice maker myself, I agree, because I mean, okay, I'm almost 40 years old, but I like Crunch Berries. I like Swiss Fish. I could eat candy all day long. So right, mean, if you're a big Captain Crunch fan, I don't see how they're saying that's aimed to bring kids into vaping. Cause adults like that same stuff.
And this is the thing I would say, you know, this vaping is popular because it has helped people kick the habit. But it's one of those things, like, people kind of, they create a community around, that everyone builds their own custom box, they've got their own custom flavor, and I think that is something that younger kids, that, you know, they look up to adults, they imitate adults. So I think it's something that kids could gravitate towards. But I think what needs to be said is, you know, this is a free country where we don't do everything by banning something or regulating it or taxing the hell out of it. And we rely on people like you in the vaping community who are actually selling these products to do it responsibly. Don't sell to kids, because, you know, if we get caught in the news and we see people who are running local stores selling e-juice with nicotine in it to 8-year-olds, it makes it hard as hell to advocate for you guys. So, exactly. You know, but that's something we really have to lean on you guys to do this in a responsible way and not sell kids.
Yeah. I mean, that's... I mean, other than I do a lot of internet sales, but most of mine I'm in like what we're in. Three online stores, a brick and mortar here local to us. So most of our stuff is going to shops where it's their job to make sure they're 18 and not mine. So,
right.
But, I mean, the ones I mainly sell to off of, are out of my groups, which I know they're over 18. Because, I mean, they're not even allowed in our group if they even look like they're under 18, which,
right.
I mean, hell, he's our trick guy, and he don't even look 18, but he's well over 18, so.
Checked his ID.
And I think you guys just need to keep hammering that message. Like, look, freedom unites people. This country is about individual freedom and individual responsibility. We gotta hammer that. We're gonna do this the right way. We're gonna be responsible businessers. We're going to value the freedoms we have as a vaping community. We're going to give people access to the market. We're going to celebrate the fact that people are kicking the habit of tobacco addiction, and you know, we're going to sell our product in a responsible way.
Right. I mean, even for me, you know, Death Drips, when I kind of fully got onto these guys, that's what really made me, because I was kind of that in between for a little bit where I was still smoking, you know, 3 or 4 cigarettes, you know, a week. And then, you know, I hit onto these guys who are a small company. And, you know, that's going to affect them the most if this bill passes. And, you know, that's, right. It's their flavors for me that finally got me to finally class cigarette and just stop and become, you know, the term, the vape vegan, you know, where I don't touch cigarettes. I don't smoke them. I completely stopped. You know, I went from 24 milligrams of nicotine and, you know, just little Evod, you know, vapes, you know, all the way down to 3 nicotine, and there's times where I can vape a whole day on 0 nicotine, and I'm okay now, you know.
Right.
Granted, I'm 23 years old now. I started smoking when I was 12. You know, I got hipped onto that from, you know, I rode the city bus to school, and, you know, the seniors who smoked, and, you know, it was cool to see. And that was early 2000s. But at the same time, you know, I was subjected to that at a young age. And for me, you know, I picked up on it and I started smoking, and then I was smoking just nonstop from that time. You know, vaping has been something to finally pull me off of it. You know, I've tried the Chantix, you know, pills to take. They just made me sick, but I still wanted to smoke. The e-cig patches broke me out. The little nicotine inhalers, the smokeless ones, they didn't work for me, you know. Right. And this is something that's actually pulled me out of that to where, you know, and I do feel healthier. I can actually say that, you know, as a living example, that, you know, I can breathe. I don't wake up, the first thing I do is cough. You know, I can breathe easier. I can smell better, taste things better. You know, I mean, there's been so many beneficial things that I've gotten from, you know. Right. And kind of to touch on the regulating smoking as far as it being a tobacco product. Now, I can understand where some people come from with that. You know, I wouldn't want to be, you know, trying to enjoy a meal at Olive Garden and, you know, I'm eating Italian food and there's a guy at a table chucking cloud after cloud. I mean, I can understand that, but it just, their regulations are going a little too far with it. So I can understand it, but regulating as a tobacco product in itself is that's the issue. Like, I can understand, like, you know, please don't vape in here, but, you know, I feel like there should be, you know, a somewhat allowance to that. You know, like, you know, they have a even a vapors area to where, you know, because I mean, back when smoking before it got out of businesses, you'd walk into like Golden Corral in Lafayette, and you on the right hand was the smoking section, on the left hand side was the non-smoking right. section.
Yeah.
And nobody had an issue with this for years. Nobody cared. I mean, they still took their children in there, all that. They weren't affected by the fact that there was a smoking section in there. and now they're, you know, gone completely without it. If you just, you know, even the small little, you know, sig-alikes will have a problem with once you do that in a restaurant or, you know, any place of business, you know, they have an issue with it. And like I said, you know, I can understand, you know, you got guys building real low and you're just stuck in a huge cloud that's just fogging everybody out. And that's, it's more respect thing with that. But for them to go as far as say, this is tobacco, well, last I knew, tobacco was a plant, you know, which is leaves, it's dried leaves and chemical additives, and you smoke it by physically, you know, lighting it on fire. And for this, you know, this is, it's vapor, you know, it's not the same, you know, makeup, concept, or any of that. The concept that those two share is, you know, the fact that you're inhaling it and exhaling it with a visible action.
Right. And I think you hit two huge points here, and I'll give you this as the first. Most people go to Gold Corral and whip out their vape and just blow the whole place up. 99.9% of people won't do that. And first I'll say is don't be that guy, because those are the guys that are going to hurt your cause. They love vaping. They'll just flaunt it, and they'll go to a place where they got kids, or, you know, it's just not appropriate. You know, if you want to take a smoke, just go outside. Don't hurt it for everybody. And the second thing I'll say is, you know, I mean, the story that you gave is probably the most powerful weapon that you have. You picked up tobacco smoking early when you were 12. You know, it became a part of your life, and now you're hooked on it. Think about how many millions and millions and millions of people share that story. My father started when he was 10 or 12, and now he's 55. He can't kick the habit. And there are generations and generations and generations of people who are unable to kick the habit. But now we have this opportunity. We didn't have to put the government program. We didn't have to pass another law. We didn't have to spend hundreds of millions of dollars to fix this problem. Vaping has been around a long time, but it became popular, and now you have millions and millions and millions of people that are kicking the habit. And, you know, inhaling e-juice vapor, is it 100% healthy? Probably not. But it sure as hell a lot healthier than smoking cigarettes.
Right.
And, you know, the vaping, it tends to be something that's tucked away. It's not as if it's a hot political issue. You're not talking about guns or abortion or budgetary items. So things like vape kind of become a little niche area where people, frankly, don't understand it at all. And if you sit down with, with political leaders, lawmakers, and you say, look, this is why this is important. This is why we can't do this. That story is your most potent weapon. You're talking to leaders, you're talking to community members and rallying them behind your cause. And I think keep telling that story and telling it over and over again is one of the most important things you could do.
There's some other because I heard that once they start regulating, if they actually get to it, FDA starts regulating the e-juice, somebody told me they're going to, government company is going to start regulating the MUDs and this and that. And I heard that if they actually do that, China is actually going to be hopping on the bandwagon, because that's going to hurt their money as well as the companies in the U.S.
You know, there's a lot of hypotheticals right now. We don't know how that's all going to play out. I think you guys understand very clearly the direction that they're looking to regulate the juice. But there's also, you know, you see the pictures posted where someone's built a box incorrectly, or maybe they've used cheaper parts and it blows up on them. So I think if whatever their final product is, you're probably also going to see, you know, technical standards, technical regulations on products themselves.
Yeah. I know a lot of it is, you've seen lately, is people putting batteries in their pockets with change.
Right. And it's another opportunity for you guys to educate and be leaders on this and say, look, we have to understand what we're dealing with here. Do not do this. Do not do this. These are the safety recommendations. You know, anybody who's serious about vaping, the first thing they want to do is have their own custom box with their own custom skin. And it's a cool thing for people to do, but not everybody understands the challenges.
Yeah.
And the more pictures we see of people in hospital rooms because they didn't understand the technical end of it, the more it's going to hurt your cause.
Yeah.
So it's another opportunity for you guys to be leaders. I mean, hell, you might do a show on what not to do and how that affected people.
And
it's
we
an
actually
opportunity
do,
for you guys to speak up.
And we actually do that, which Astrona made the point, which I didn't actually say. It's not just the batteries for your mods and your vape pens or whatever. It's any battery, the AA buy down at Dollar General. They'll blow up, you throw them in your pocket. So it's not just vape batteries, but it's... But we make sure we always, every show we have battery safety on every show.
And kudos to you guys. I mean, that's great. And I'd continue to do that. Once every show, we did this, and it's blown up, this is what you should do and what you shouldn't do.
Yeah.
I mean, and common sense also does come in to an extent. I mean, you know, you would put a 9-volt battery in your pocket, you know, knowing that positive negative is there. And I know we've all done it. We've done something to make it spark or, stuck it to our tongue or something like that. You know, we've all done it now. And it just, we know, sticking a 9-volt battery in your pocket, we know that's a high power battery, and the potential to hurt us. And see, the issue I'm seeing with a lot of these, just watching these videos, watching breakdowns of these videos, is a lot of times is, usually when you see an exploded vape pen or any type of mod that deals with an 18650 battery, or any type of lithium or battery, is you're finding these people who are sticking, the wrong things with the wrong items. Like a lot of your tanks, they don't have the safety feature, which is an exposed 510 pin, which is your positive lead. So your negative leads are the threads, and that pin is the only positive section of that. Well, a lot of times your Spire Atlantis tanks, which I'm seeing a lot of, these blown up, they don't, it sits flush. So when you put that on a mechanical mod or a hybrid top, that they charge, that pin sitting flush. So as soon as you hit that, whatever mechanism you use to fire it with the firing button, you're putting that positive pin straight up there with negative as well, and that is causing the hard short, which is called, the venting, explosions, sparks, just all these things that are happening, and that's the issue, is there is a lack of understanding of the battery safety. Before I got, a mechanical mod myself, I got a regulated device, I learned battery safety. And it's simple things that people do. They don't want to take the time to learn it because, that's just, little thing, or this or that. Or they're starting going into building and they're not understanding Ohm's Law. And you just have to have the most basic understanding of Ohm's Law to build safely. And
I think that's a huge point. Common sense should prevail. I think, for the most part, common sense does prevail. But, I couldn't even begin to, I didn't understand what you just elaborated about that. And it's the technical, it's little technical details that I think get people. Just little explanations like that, I think, are going to help the community, overall.
Just, I know LiPo mods are getting really, really big right now. And I've already had one myself. I got with them traded up, but I'm getting ready to another one. But it's going to run like 16 volts. And that's actually what I was going to cover last week, and I, hopefully if I run over after we're done, but I may go ahead and cover this week since I missed last week, the safety on light batteries. You have to follow it to the T or you will blow yourself up.
Right, right. Absolutely. And I mean, the technology is going to continue to change, you know, it's just going to change and there's nothing you can do to stop it. So the best thing you can do, especially if you don't want to have the government hanging behind you and regulating the hell out of all your products, get ahead of the game and explain to people challenges as technology evolves.
Right. Because, I mean, LiPo battery is not one, I mean, you see them on the hoverboard, you see them in the RC cars, you see, I mean, they use them for a lot of different things. And if you, it's like the, you see on the hoverboards, they've been blowing up or catching fire or whatever. It's because them hoverboards have the LiPo as well, and if you don't charge them the proper way, they're going to catch fire.
And that's, you know, it's things like this. I'll give you an example. You know, energy across the country is a great debate. How do we shift towards clean energy? One of the big reasons that residential solar isn't viable, it's because the battery technology isn't allowing the storage for the product to be effective. Man. So there's a great study right now about evolving battery technology in general. And you never know how that's going to affect me. I mean, that could affect everything is a battery if someone comes out with a new technology that allows for extended use. And that's just a hypothetical, but it's just an example of how you don't know how technology is going to change shapes. So stay ahead of that and educate yourself, and that way you can educate others.
Definitely. So, babe, come here. I want your help for a minute. Let her sit down for a second. I'm going to pause for a minute. Normally we do it sporadically, but I'm going to pause for a minute so we can do a giveaway for the guys here listening. Just kind of get a little fun going. We're talking all this, if you don't mind waiting a couple minutes.
Sure.
Okay.
I do this shortly, but I'll wait for a couple minutes.
Okay. Yeah, it won't take long. Let's see.
I can't do it from my tab.
Yeah. Okay, right now, let's see, what are we going to do? Let's start off with one of our newest sponsors, guys, Zombie Juice. Let me make sure that's, there we go.
We are so freaking excited. So,
yeah, so we're going to do a 30-ml bottle of Zombie Juice. Clear chat.
Well, we want to do randoms. You guys want to do randoms or not? Randoms probably where?
No, I don't.
Control C. Okay.
We'll talk later, man.
No, I do.
Here's the links, guys. Go show some love. And, yeah. Here's the actually what they'll come and look like
when they come in. They got sweet.
The sticker, they got the bottle with the cap, then they got a little twist cap and a little vape band. So, yes, Mala, Robin, Mr. Grammer, I don't know how you want to be dressed. Hey, so
yeah, I use MVP.
Cool. All right, well, let's clear the chat. We're just going to do 6 randoms. Get one out, so.
Piss her on.
All right, 6 randoms, baby. All right,
hold
on.
It's that random, right?
Yep.
Because I could do something. Hold on. Give me a minute, right?
Yep.
Get me.
Oh, crap.
Hold on, Jeff's messing up my case.
Wrong.
Let me do it again.
Random. Okay, copy.
How many are we doing?
Six.
Three.
Yeah. Only gotta hit enter first.
So. Now that's dark.
Three. Four. Five. Aww. The very
win. West stage win. Are you paying attention?
The first, I'm not gonna read the stories right now, but you got banana pie, immunity, dream, raging tang, isolation, the quarantine, zombie chomp, and zombies. Yeah, she got zombie.
You copied and saved.
No.
Winter's form isn't working, guys.
Yeah, Winter's form's not working.
So we have to do this a different way. So we're going to shift this up.
Okay, we'll go there. Fill it out, send it to our email.
You're gonna type us an email.
Yeah, send us an email.
Put your name, script. We know who you are, so you know, your first name, last name, birthday. We're good with that. We know who you are, honey.
And
I'm just put whatever that you want, and then your nick level.
And then hereafter, we'll get back to him. Let's get some more applications going, and I'll actually sit and read all the flavor profiles. So. Sorry about that. We do quite a few giveaways from our sponsor. Wanted to get one in there, so.
So I'm gonna go back to chat, Robin, and okay. I'm gonna have Cody come back over. He's doing good.
So, but anyway, but
take it.
Yeah, it's like I said, our shows are fun, but. We're more on safety, advocation, learning. So, we get quite a bit out there. So.
Good, good.
So, but, yeah, that's something I was going to add. I know they vetoed the taxation over there in Maryland. They other that even if it failed, they're sneaking in like through the back door, would try to bring it back up in Maryland.
So, I don't see. They really have to pull a quick one to get that done. In Maryland, the way the legislative process is, we would see coming before. It would have any chance of getting passed. Okay. I don't see it happening anytime soon. But you know, if anybody here in Maryland does see it, please go to our website robin.com. We have ways that we got to our office there, and we'll be sure to rally on this one.
Yeah. Let me find. Is your website on your Facebook also, or?
I think so. It should be robingrover.com. Let me see. Take a quick peek here. Yeah. Yeah, if you want to put the link to my Facebook there, it also has a link to the website.
All right. Yeah, I'll put. What the heck? I just went all. Hey,
did they walk away?
Something.
Come on, give him goodbye.
We got this. are we still on?
Yeah. Yes,
you are.
Okay. Something that I want to bring. Robin, are you still with us here?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. Something that I wanted to bring up is from what I've heard, because I had went to a cloud competition in Fort Wayne at a Craig Babes Georgetown. Something that I had spoke to them and some of the spawn or those guys was they did say that a lot of the proceeds, especially for like the comp juice, especially that they was going to a lobbyist that they have. I don't know if maybe we should try to get in with them, or you know, I kind of want your you know, that would be an option, because from what they say is they themselves do have a lobbyist, and a lot of the proceeds and a lot of these benefits that come from comps and you know, just special sales, things like that, go towards the lobbyist. But I don't know if maybe that could be a potential option for us to go through, or if we, as the community that's kind of locale where we're at, especially being, you know, close to Lafayette and where this company is, that is going to be the one that kind of monopolizes on this bill that's going to pass, you know, right. If we ourselves should take towards that or link up with someone that has a lobbyist for that.
There are a lot of different ways to advocate. One thing I would do is really, you know, make a connection with a lawmaker that is an advocate. If they're a vapor, if they feel passionate about the issue, that's probably one of the strongest things you're going to do. Having, you know, an official lobbyist to be the advocate for the community, that's another big part of it. I don't know the science of lobbying personally. I've always either been an activist or now I'm acting as an elected official, so I'm not sure what the science is there. But the third thing, I've mentioned this previously, is really just be a community leader. There's an undeniable power in having any community speak up for an issue. You know, just think about it. How big is the vaping community in your area, in your district, in your state? Is it 5%? Is it 10%? Is it 8%? I mean, how many people actually use vapes for recreation or to kick a tobacco habit? Whatever it is, whether it's 5% or 10% or 3%, it's a huge amount of people, and that's there's an undeniable power in that. If you're acting against the community, you're in trouble, and you're going to be held accountable. So I wish I had a better answer for you specifically on the lobbyist question. I would most certainly include in your arsenal, but also continue to be leaders.
Okay. Now, this is a little off topic, kind of, but whenever you go, send me your address where I want to send you a bottle of each of our flesh from me and my wife's line, just for you coming on.
I appreciate that.
So, just whenever you have time, send me your address. We want to send you all the flavors.
Send me something small. We actually can't give over a certain monetary value, so I would keep it under $20 if you can.
Oh, no problem.
I'd appreciate that, though.
Okay, we got another question. Is it true that the majority of supporters for vaping rights are Republicans?
You know, I hesitate to generalize, because you're speaking really broadly at this point.
Yeah.
I'll just speak practically from my experience, and I'll say yes. The people, the lawmakers that tend to advocate for more taxes, more regulation, more banning of anything in general, are generally Democrats. And you typically find that people who are more inclined to give people freedoms over personal habits are Republicans. I'm a Republican. You know, I just happen to be a vapor, but even if I didn't use the product, I still see a prime value and really a philosophical argument to letting people run their lives as they see fit. You have a lot of people in the legislature these days who you know, not seeing an overwhelming problem with people vaping, but they have they're kind of bent on the desire to regulate the hell out of everything. You know, there's a problem in my district where the state had shut down a coffee stand for disabled students. It's a coffee stand for disabled students. Wow. And, you know, I think that I'm going to pass a bill this year to fix that. But I had to play hell to do that. And I hope that speaks to your question. But generally, Republicans are more inclined to not regulate, to not tax, to not ban or put a law into place that controls how products like these are used. And in my experience, we've had a couple bills in regard to e-cigarette regulation in Maryland. All the people that voted against it were Republicans, but unfortunately they did pass.
I know we had another one. I don't really... Somebody asked, how many lobbyists does the opposition have, though? I mean...
We can kind of put that, like, as far as your standpoint, because I kind of know where he's going with that. But, you know, basically, it's kind of a question of exactly, you know, kind of in your standpoint. I know that you're in Maryland and we're in Indiana, but just kind of generalized idea. What exactly are we facing, you know, from your standpoint, like what you and your, from your example, you know, what kind of stuff we're going to run into as far as lobbyists from your standpoint, just to kind of give us an example of what we might run into in Indiana.
So, and this is the deal with lobbying, but you typically won't see it unless people start to go to war over an issue. You know, in most states, I know in Maryland and probably in your state as well, the list of registered lobbyists is public. But you're never going to see a lobbyist, you're never going to see it if they start to bend the ear of your lawmaker or any lawmaker. And that's, you will see the end result, and the end result's going to be a company like Philip Norris or whomever, some giga corporation, is going to carve themselves out, they're going to carve a large part of the market out for themselves. It's really hard to answer, but the end result you're never going to see. It's going to happen in a discussion somewhere that's frankly never going to be, it's not going to be part of public debate. It's going to happen in a committee, it's going to happen in a room, it's going to happen on an amendment that frankly you won't see. And that's why I tend to veer away from the lobbying end of it. It's a really hard thing to control. And I keep veering towards, for you guys, you know, you're working with your community. You probably know people that vape in your community. You probably have lists of supporters, people on the ground, the grassroots side of things. It's really hard to challenge the lobbying side of things, except when you start to hold people accountable. Like, if you have a roll call vote of legislators who have voted against the vaping community, I mean, you get an opportunity to hang them out to dry. You get an opportunity to hold them accountable. And that's very powerful. And that's, you know, that's probably the strongest thing to combat the amendment, the carve out. You know, you get an opportunity to see these guys supported giga corporation, but they're not supporting the people in their district who use this to kick a 20-year. So I think I spoke to that point a little bit, but I sincerely believe the grassroots part of being an advocate is stronger than the lobbying part.
Yeah. Okay. Now I got it was just a comment, but we had Astorana, which is so. Astorana is the one that was also emailing you as well, sending you over my direction, but she made a comment. She said, thank you so much, Rara, for everything and representing us, and she sent you an email.
Absolutely, and I appreciate that. I think we've exchanged all emails. Yes. And I know if you find lawmakers there that are supportive and becoming champions of your issue, you know, make sure you support them because you know most people don't understand. But in Maryland and I think in most other places, lobbyists actually don't have any money, but they become the hidden advocate for interests that you know you'll never see. And a lot of time, you get a kid like this, you really hang yourself out to dry. Someone in your state, whatever your state is, you know, make sure you sign up one, follow, pitch them a small donation every now and then.
Yeah, well, that's what we're still trying to find. So find a list, find some actually for the cause and not against it here in Indiana. All right.
Have you talked with your lawmaker yet?
No, I'm not really sure where what step to take to find those, but
he would say, look, we have hundreds or thousands of followers, and what we'd like was what's your position on this, and would you be willing to go to, you know, the fight for us over this issue?
Yeah.
And they have to answer that question, and they have to say, no, I'm sorry, I can't be with you, or yeah, stand up for it, and I prefer you bringing the information to me. And you'll find that most lawmakers, they're going to listen to people that vote, and they're going to be very responsive to the concerns that you have.
You gonna come in? Okay. Yeah, about 3:30. Yeah, like I said, I really appreciate you taking time, Connor. Anybody else have any questions or?
What? If you guys have any questions, this feels like a good point to say do.
Yeah, definitely. So, and feel free anytime you hear of anything coming towards Maryland, anything, feel free to let me know, or feel free, you're welcome to come back to the show, share any new information or anything else. So.
Appreciate it. If you guys want to follow me, the website is robingrammer.com. And if you ever have any loss in Maryland that is coming down the pipe, make sure and reach out to me and we'll see what we can do to help.
All right. Cool. Like I said, I greatly appreciate it. And make sure to send me your address. I want to send you some little sample bottles of our line for you.
All right. Appreciate it, guys. Have a good one.
All right. Have a good day.
You too.
See ya.
Mate. All right, guys.
Tell him I'm listening. I'm getting zombies tied up
right now. Oh,
Jake just missed it.
Oh
you just missed it, Jake.
is that our Jake?
No, that's not our Jake.
No.
That's Jake Babes.
Okay. So then I need to add.
This seat got really hot really fast.
Make sure the other camera's plugged in. All right, guys. Now, how was that? Now, was that not like some cool shit or what? Anyway. Where's that card at?
I'm typing it up right now.
I want to read them all, so.
I've been sitting here typing them the whole time. The whole freaking time. I'm almost done. I'm down to two.
Really? So, as I was saying, we actually have two new sponsors, which Astorana was the first winner of the new sponsor. She won a 30 mil Zombies e-juice. Elf, I helped the right way up.
Can you read it upside down? Because he was doing really good with the upside down thing.
So, yeah, definitely following. And
don't take it away from me.
Okay, and the other good news is our second new sponsor, I mean, obviously you've seen some change, Gothic Vapor, right there. She is giving away 125 mil of juice a week. Winner's choice. And they've got over 300 flavors.
Oh my god. It's crazy.
Yes, Zomberries. And not only 300 flavors, they have no, it's not in the cool bottle. So I wish.
No, they're just the regular bottles.
I really wish so. But yeah, she's gonna give away 125 mil every week. And not only is that the 300 flavors, there is a create your own flavor or juice. You can name it, you can make your own creation, and they'll actually, once they make it with your name, they'll sell it on the create your own juice tab with the same name and the same flavor. So yeah,
see, there's some things I don't know all of yet. I've been at work like all week. I've been crazy so, working this
yes
month.
So zombies, e-juice, gothic vaping, two really, really freaking excited to have them. I mean, 300 plus flavors. That
okay. Now, bear with me, because it's going to be really long. I've been typing this for a while now.
Instead of me reading it, she's going to post it.
I was already down to, like, two, all right? So bear with me, because I've been typing this whole time. You guys have all been talking. This is Zombies Eel Juice list of flavors and profiles. The capital part is the name. The flavor list is behind it. Jeff can read them to you, too, because, you know, that's a lot.
All right. So, damn, what the heck? Did I not? Hold on, let me.
I'm not even on.
Why? It shows
I'm
you.
On a lag. Do you guys not see me?
Oh.
I'm going to confuse everybody.
I see why.
You put me on the screen, did you? It'll
why
stop.
Is it?
It lags.
It still should have went up once I clicked on it. That's a major lag.
Now you guys are going to post this up to YouTube, correct?
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah, it'll all be used to YouTube, so. And any of you guys that did miss it, let me post the YouTube channel. I actually have a YouTube channel started for Vape in the Crypt, so I can record every show and save it.
Australian, I haven't tried them all yet. Jeff sat here and vaped, like, everyone tried them all when they came in. He brings me one at work. One. Brings me one flavor at work. Him and Cody were so gracious to bring that to me at work. It was so sweet of them. But one. That's what I got. But I love the one he did bring me. So, and that was the, what was it, Zombie? No.
I brought you the.
It's on the back. The last one. Undead Scream.
I brought her that.
I love the Undead Scream. Aegis Fate knows exactly what I'm talking about.
I'll tell you what, my favorite is the Zomberries, the Raging Contagion, and let's see, Zomberries, Raging Contagion, and the Brainana Pie. Those three are freaking amazing.
I did get Craven Vape's
right. Who?
Craven Vape's right account's phone number. I'm going to call them out their lobby.
The Zombie Chop.
See if I can't get
it's good. I like it.
Just because.
But like I said, my three favorites are the Brainana Pie, Zomberries, and Raging Contagion.
Hey, you want to be me?
No. That's yours.
No.
You don't want to be me?
You can sit your butt down there.
I was saying if you want us to be me in chat.
Oh, no, because I'm not you.
We can put a wig on you.
Oh, no.
Yeah.
Like right now,
I gotta go get my vape and my stuff because I've got.
Cody. I'm doing the Brainana Pie right now, and
I've got Cody's situation over there, honey. You're like stationed.
Okay.
Over there. Oh yeah. No,
now we, the guest is gone.
Oh yeah. What's going on?
I see.
Let's check this out.
I'm gonna give you guys a call.
Okay.
Oh. I'm gonna give them a call. Keep going.
Be able to do it Sunday though.
Probably not.
Well, they should be open by now, actually. Come by. Was he a senator?
Yeah, this is mine.
Robin?
Yeah.
He was a delegate.
Delegate
Graham. Right. Sorry, you're going to. I'm bored situating.
But it's a. I've got stacked with two 18-350s. Then it's got a cartomizer tank.
Gauges are coming up. Oh my god, it hurt. Stop. Yeah, see, now Jeff's gonna, he's gonna start playing around and then. And he's not gonna talk. Sorry, guys. He can't do two things.
I got this. She actually, only does them for certain people, but it's at Sin City Mods. Check them out and tell them I sent you, and she'll probably make you one.
Maybe. Busy she is.
Because, well, it don't matter how busy she's only limiting her sales to certain people. And I've dealt with her since 2011, so, and I've bought quite a few cans from her in the past. So, I'm still able to get them, and they're all hand-blown glass straws.
Sorry, I'm trying to answer a question real quick.
But check out...
Puke on yourself much. I get to say that now because it's just you and I in here. Now the gross begins. No, I'm kidding. we're all back to regular. Let's all get. Where's Chicken?
Where the fuck's Chicken at anyway?
Yeah, part of the Maryland crew in here, but where's the Chicken? Let's see, who else are we missing? We're missing Feek. Where's Feek?
Right.
That was the other one. I was trying to think of where Feet and what his name was off the top of my head. I was going to tell him by his real name. Well, you know what? It's because Feek and Chicken are hanging together. They're out partying somewhere drinking.
Right.
They ain't coming in here today.
He skipped going to watch the show. Feek's playing board games at a friend's house. He'd rather come watch me than
watch you. It's just you. Who do you like better, Age of Fate? Is it me? It's me because I'm better looking, right? He's just goofy.
No, he likes coming to see me and my show.
You're so full of yourself. Somebody,
right? Yeah. Okay. Good one there.
Good cover up, Mike. We'll talk later. That's okay. I'm taking Cody's car for a ride here in a minute.
Are you?
Yep. I'm going to take it and wear a crumb of a cruising in it.
That's all right.
Oh, yeah. It drunk Chicken. We'd be in trouble if he was drunk.
That'd be funny, Chicken.
It's $181.25 every 2 weeks. Plus about $100-some in insurance.
Jesus Christ.
No.
I guess we don't have to worry about me staying or getting dehydrated. Hell, I just bought this morning before the show. I drank almost that whole thing during talking to Robin. All right.
Sorry, I'm discussing automobile issues. So I'm jumping around.
I did call Greg Babes. They didn't answer. I didn't leave a message. My phone number.
Okay.
I'm going to try to see if I can't get some type of group chat. Something. I don't know. We're going to have to kind of break it down. Try to get some type of Indiana.
Drank almost that whole thing just talking to him in like an hour.
It's because you're sucking it down through your straw. Go to the bathroom. Go.
I definitely killed my whole thing. It was a full throttle.
Hey, somebody's pull king or something because shit ain't here to do it. Now it's 45 minutes.
You can go step to the bathroom for a minute. Cody can sit in your place. He can do it. He said this morning.
I can pick on people if you need me to.
Just go. Jesus. Here. Seriously? All right. This is now the Cody and Colleen show. I'm sorry, man. I'm like all over
now your station over here and shit.
Hey, I just set my shit on top of your shit. How it works. So now we're going to switch over to Cody Colleen show. Forget Jeff. He's gone. Kicked him out. We're done. He probably won't be gone. I'll just put it that way. Let's see. Hold on. See, Cody's going to do it. He's going to do tricks. Why am I? I think you need to go. Am I going by that? I don't want to remember. You need to do that way.
I'm way off here.
What's because you get your on camera?
Oh, yeah. I was...
There, can everybody see us?
This guy.
We got Cody and me. Sunshine and, you know, sunshine and what do you want to be? You could be sunshine and I'll be the dark cloud.
I've got the blonde highlights. Hey, I'll be something.
All right, so let's see. Let's see if I can do a giveaway while he's gone. Shut your mouth. Let's see here. Let's try.
Yeah, I noticed that.
Yeah. Because I think we're right now. Yeah, it was you. It's Jeff, actually.
I stuck blonde paper down there for a reason.
Oh, shoot! Hi, Amber, how are you?
Feel that drop of juice flying in the eye. I was actually driving some crud off my coils on my Kennedy, and while I was dry burning on my Kennedy to get that gunk off my coils, it was like popped and just flew straight into my eye. And that sucked. So I definitely feel you on that fate. That sucks.
That's not one of those. Hey, that tickles. No, generally not so pretty. Let's see. I am going to. You're slip tarded, or you're slip tard, slip knot, or slip tard. Which do you want to be today? We can you could be both. Just whichever you want to go with. Look at you go.
I got a lot better.
I can't do a giveaway. Cody's doing tricks, man. I'm all mesmerized.
Okay, go ahead.
There's no giveaways because I'm like stuck in here. Let's see and find it. What did I say?
Sorry.
Oh no, you're fine.
Yes, Astron, I can do the jellyfish.
You've got my chat over there.
Yeah. It's pretty awesome. I just, with this very small area I'm sitting in right now, I cannot do it.
And I can't get the camera to, like...
We don't have that cool...
What is that? It's your copy control. Borrow Jake's
GoPro for you. So you can get that 720 views.
There we go. Okay, I'm going to post up a link real quick. I'll try to. If I can get it to do it the way it's supposed to. This is, everybody should go over and support CASA, and the Vaping Militia.
Which member?
One we added to today, we added last week, is Hoosier Vapors. We are from Indiana, so we figured that HoosierVapors.org would be an awesome thing to have up on our page. I spelled that wrong. Huh? I didn't spell it wrong. He typed it in. He did the link for that one, not me. Let's not grammar Nazi it, because Jeff's not the best with grammar. Way to go, babe. Grammar Nazi caught you on your grammar here. You put there. You spelled there wrong, just so you know. So we're just going to point that all out. There we go. Somebody's donating to grammar schooling for you, babe. Oh, I think you do.
That's a British term for cigarettes. Interesting.
Yeah.
Yeah, no. No,
yeah, it is. Donate, babe. Yeah, I don't think that's cool. All right, back on topic. Why are we doing that? Well, let's just start over. All right, guys. Also here at on the Villain Network. Oh, I can't remember. It's Control C. Yeah.
Control C. Control V to paste.
Okay. Control C. And
Control B.
Control what?
Control B.
B?
The B as in boss.
That?
I got that keyboard status down. I used to do a lot of copying and pasting back in high school.
What are you doing?
This is. No. No. Yes. Cloud Chuck, is there a reason why you're coming in and just spamming them with stuff? Birdie. You, please stop.
Hit him with the band hammer.
All right.
Hold on.
I'm done.
Hold on.
Okay, there's one. Guys, we are not doing this. We're not going to play this. We're here for education and to learn. We're not here to come in and ruin a show. Not playing that game. Won't play that game. So, if you don't want to be in here and seriously be in here, then so
get
be it.
Get the fuck out.
Get out.
No, I ain't get out. Get the fuck out.
We're not playing games, okay? You want to have fun, you want to do giveaways, that's awesome, that's cool, but it's, you know, stuff like that, that's what causes problems in groups, that's what causes shows to get shut down. Exactly. It is very childish, Gregory, and it's not going to happen. Needless to say, they're both gone. They will be brought up. It'll be taken care of. Sorry about that, guys. It was just a matter of I was trying to figure out what I needed to go about doing as far as writing everything down so we know what to report.
All I can say, it would have been very, very ugly. He wasn't signed in, but he's watching the room. If they would have pulled that shit while we had delegate grammar in here,
yeah,
all hell would have fucking broke loose. I don't play the bullshit. Unless it's giving her hell, then it's a whole different story. But
that's a different story. We live together. I could smack you around if I want to. Anyway, now go where I was. I was going into. Okay, let's get back to our show. Let's do the real stuff now.
Okay, so let's start off with.
No, I already had it all set up what I wanted to do, and then freaking.
Which one?
Hold on, I gotta find the list again. Sorry, guys. Now I'm all flustered. We were doing Space Monkey, and I was going to do that, but I was posting up the villain project and everything, and that's when they started doing that.
Okay. All right.
Came out with the band hammer.
It's called Throw It Down.
And if any of you are in my groups, you'll know the band hammer comes out quite frequently. I don't play the bullshit, so...
Oh, okay. We got our lead for the other one. I found out what the other giveaway was that we're giving away today.
Which one?
For Cast Me On.
All right. Ghost Show. Yeah. ask Eddie. He knows I don't play the shit.
We've had several groups, and Eddie's been in several of our groups. We just closed one down today because we've got so much going on.
But go like Space Monkey, show them some love. We're going to give away 2 30-mil bottles to 2 winners. So.
Somebody young. I don't know. Cody, do you bring young people up in a group into like them really young 20s and stuff? Because you know all them young people. You bring anybody up in this room that don't know how to act like an adult?
No. What? No. The guy in the right screen. It's lag. He's not a younger kid. Well, I mean, he's younger than us by far, but he's 23.
He's over here throwing his hands going, I'm 23.
He's actually our trick guy. We sponsor 2 guys for Trick Comp. He comes sits in every once in a while. So
that he's really good at talking.
Yeah, that ain't no shit.
So I like to let him
put
talk.
It this way. He's got me some shit from us shooting the shit, and I went home to answer the wife's call. So, posted Hoosier.
Did you post the wrong thing?
No, it says Space Monkey.
Click on it and see what it takes you to.
Yeah, no, I'm done.
That's Space Monkey.
Okay. I posted Hoosier earlier.
Yeah.
I was posted the different link, and that's when they came and started throwing all their crap in and kind of threw all my stuff. Yeah.
Yeah, she posted the Hoosier Vapors Advocacy Group. The head of it was the one that was on our group last week, so.
If it's misspelled or there's any misspelling in it, that'd be Jeff. Just
blame it on me.
It's because you did it. The grammar police caught you, Cody caught it, so, and it wasn't even me.
I know it's different. I've added that compared to what everybody else has on their screen, just because I am a Hoosier, and what he's doing to get them to stop the shit in Indiana, I felt I needed to have their links on my page.
Mona Death. I'm Mona Death? What are you doing, Eddie? You can't type today?
Damn, Edwin. She wants to bitch about my grammar. Look at you.
Yeah, I didn't bitch about it. He did it. I just brought it to you.
So
anyway, so let's go over. Let's give Space Monkey some love because we got 2 bottles, 2 30-mil bottles to give away.
And the Space Monkey. And the flavor profiles as follows. You got the blueberry bombshell.
Oh my god.
Yes, I got the can mod. Hell yeah. The blueberry bombshell is a blueberry glazed donut.
Have Cody read him. He can read really good.
Just Freaking Peachy, which is a peach ring. Oh, yeah. Tropic Thunder jackfruit mix. Lady Luck pineapple coconut.
Oh, I can make them huge. I've been working on that one.
Busty Melons is a watermelon candy. Dreamy Dragon is Dragon Fruit Mix. Cosmic Split, Banana Split. Bananarama is a banana cream. Nookie Cookie is a fresh oatmeal cookie. And a Starburst Strawberries is creamy strawberries. So, that's the flavor profiles that on Space Monkey. So, everybody go show them some love. And also, if you don't win, you can go order juice there. And the code for Space Monkey is Vape in the Crypt. And you get 15% off of your order. So if you don't win, go check them out. Check out the juices. Got some awesome juices. And you get 15% off by typing in Vape in the Crypt. So.
Oh, hey, give me the book. This book. We're gonna have to do giveaway.
I know. And her nick levels are Blueberry Donut. I have not had that one yet. It's actually, that one's on the way to me now.
We got a couple of them on the way in.
So,
we're waiting for them to get here.
Yeah. But the nick levels are 0, 1.5, 3, and 6. And they're all max VG. So, I know people that have had the Blueberry Donut. They love it. Me, I personally have not, waiting for it to come. Because one, I do want to try. So,
just got a new one too, and we'll probably announce it on the next one because I don't know the name of it yet. I kind of have an idea of what the taste
messenger.
Is. You spit on me.
Sorry.
Nasty. What are you doing?
But anyway, as the minute I announce the new flavor today is when it's available. It is a.
It's like a ice cream. It's a fried ice cream. I gotta find where I'm at. Okay. Yes, I got that, Katara. That's where we were waiting.
Hey, Katara.
We were waiting to hear back from you. I did get your message. You didn't obviously see my message I sent you either. Oh, so he wasn't paying attention to me.
Okay. That's not the group one. Find the group one. She said it was a, crap. I can't even remember what it was now.
Spaceman, I think it's, is it Dandy? Am I saying it right? I mean, I kind of know you're wrong, but I'm not going to say it. she's actually a friend of ours. She's been in several of our groups. We've known her for quite a while. So we got up and hooked up with her and started talking, and
I've had a few of her flavors. I haven't had the whole lot today, so
we found out, we actually didn't realize it was her. We've talked to them. I believe it's her boyfriend. They were making mods. And we've discussed a lot with them before in the past over getting mom, and found out that Jeff heard about, you know, their juice and stuff. We had tried it before. And he's like, I'm gonna message them personally. So he did. We'll come to find out it happened to be her, and she's a friend of ours. So we knew and decided we'd ask, and she jumped on. Very excited. She's awesome. Awesome to deal with. Very awesome.
The ones I have had.
And that's okay, Katara. Yeah. You're allowed to sleep in. It's Sunday.
But everything is recorded and is going to Vape in the Crypt on YouTube. So I'll share the link here for you guys. And then you can watch the shows like the Head of Hoosier Vapors last week. Or
so if you miss a show, you can always go on and watch a show. You don't get to miss us. You can watch this show, our shows every day.
But the ones I have had from Space Monkey is Lady Luck, which is the pineapple coconut, the Busty Melons, which is a watermelon candy. I've had those two, and they're freaking awesome. I love them. But like I said, if you don't win, go to her page. do your order, give her the code Vape in the Crypt, you get 15% off your order. So
she must be sleeping. She's been working.
Yeah, she's been working too. Crazy hours. So
okay, so we're doing what space? You know?
Yep, 230 mils.
Okay, well, space. I'm trying to write my notes.
Okay, so we'll.
You're not gonna do that yet.
Why?
You're gonna ask first. We're gonna see. What do our people want? Do we want randoms? Do we want numbers? Before we start clearing the room, Jeff can't type, so we're good. Not see? You can't type.
Hush.
Okay, actually, I'm gonna clear the room. You guys let me know, random or numbers? And I know I just like totally bleeped you out, but I seen you, so I got one random.
All right, wake up, peeps. Randos or numbers?
Okay, we get random. Random. Hey, we're good. Cool. We'll just go with randoms. Nick, let's pick out what do you want to do? A number from what?
It is for the Space Monkey. It's 230 mils of Space Monkey.
So we're gonna do two runs. We're gonna do one run, and then we're gonna do another run, and those are gonna be the winners.
13 really ages. Stay. 13 is our number.
That's for DDV, baby.
Yes, Katara, they do have awesome juice. And if you don't win, you can get a 15% off code Vape in the Crypt through Vape Space Monkey. So, 31, what?
Really? Ward, what are you doing trying to kill me over here?
Okay, that's my lucky numbers, 13 and 31.
That's why they're 31 and 13, Goody.
I know, but I never give anybody 31, so I just go with 13.
Cody says 6. Who else said 6? Anybody?
I don't know. Amber had the first. Say 13 for ours, so 13 be for 10.
DDV. Okay, we'll do 10.
10 close.
Goodness gracious. 99. Oh my goodness.
99 ran. What the hell are you smoking? Damn.
You don't know how hard this really is to do. It's not hard. It's just time consuming.
Right?
All right. I'll
clear the damn thing.
We're going to do 10, right?
Yep.
Is that what we did? Okay. Random. You don't have to copy it, do you? Control C. Control C. Ha! Why'd you do that?
Copy.
You freaking dork. So what did you say? It's Control V, right?
Yeah.
Okay. 1, 2. Wrong one. 2. Where'd it go? My bad.
3, 4, 5, 6. So 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Oh my
freaking
goodness.
Really?
Wow, we're not gonna win it. We've got our own. I know, rigged. Completely rigged, just because Jeff's trying to do it. Let's try this again. Ready? 1, 2, 3, 4.
5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Grats!
What a winner, dude! Stop telling them what it is! If they're supposed to pay attention, remember? Jesus.
Alright, Ed, pay attention.
Totally is just like, hey, quit. They're supposed to be paying attention in the room, goofball. Do you know what you won?
Space Monkey,
right.
There you go. All right. There's our email. Send us that info and pick your flavor.
Okay, now on...
No, the 2016 Chevy goes to me.
Now...
Hold on, we gotta do the second one.
Okay, hold on. We'll end up telling you the rest of how to fill that out here in a minute. Because Jeff is impatient and won't do anything the way it's supposed to be done. Things 3 times. I'll repeat things 3 times. Do you want to do the show by yourself today?
Spell that right.
Oh my god. See, this is why you're not allowed to have the keyboard. Cody.
What?
It's Cody and Pauline show again. Kick Jeff off. All right, we're doing 10 more. Are you ready?
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. Big Mike! Woo! Grats.
What'd you win? And you... I'm walking away. That's why you can't do that middle of me doing something.
Where did it go?
It was at the top.
It's not there now.
At the top. You're not going completely to the top.
Pip to Slipknot? Cool. Alright, so, okay. I bet I already got.
So,
where the hell is it?
Move. Let me have the mouse for a minute. Yeah, no, you know, I like to be close.
No, that's where I had it. Is that top second page gone? It's right there above that.
Oh, sweet. That's really
sweet. Nice.
Go over to your chat and pull it back.
If you actually might be able to hit Control Z on the page, it'll revert whatever.
All right. Well, I got damn.
Through me. Through me. I sent it.
I wasn't.
Yeah.
Why?
Okay, so now that I have to go this way, who did he piff to? Slipknot, right?
Copy. All right. Go to that email, fill out the info.
Okay, well, to fill out the email, let me go back to that now. Ed, if you're paying attention to the show, on that, when you fill out the win, she is the juice for Space Monkey is Max VG. So the only thing you really need to select is the Nick level and your flavor on that one for Space Monkey. Her Nick levels are 0, 1.5, 3, and 6.
So pick your flavor, pick your Nick level.
That's what you need to do on that form. Is you're going to put in there, instead of doing your PGVG, you're going to pick your Nick level, or you're going to say what you want, your email address, your address.
With this.
You're going to put all that in there, and... you did the emotes in there. You catch their sweetheart. Oh, that's fine. Here, let me give you the email address since it didn't get placed back in there. Sleepy Slutty was paying attention. That's the email address. Obviously, Jeff's having a rough day.
I don't like that.
Cody.
It's just the Sunday day.
Is it?
It's a Sunday blah. We're all going through it.
That's okay. He can't type either. He can't type.
Technically, depending on whatever religion you follow, or even if you do. So Sunday is the first day of the week.
It is. No, it's Monday. It's Sunday.
It's fixed.
The Monday of Sunday.
There.
So.
You got a... Oh, the actual winner's form's working?
Is it who? Who said the winner's form was working? Did you really?
Hell yeah!
Oh, yeah! It wasn't working early this morning. We tried before we went on.
Okay. So you guys go fill out that form. Vape in the crypt with death drips. And pick your flavor and your Nick level.
Yeah, if you want to go ahead and do that too, Astriana, that'd be cool.
Yeah, because...
So that way we're keeping them all formal, yeah. You know, together the way they're supposed to be.
Okay, cool.
So, we were just having prep last night that we couldn't get anything to pull on.
It wasn't working this morning, Mom, when you setting up for the call with the...
we did a quick run to see what was working and wasn't working. So, I'm glad they said probably 5 hours to get it fixed.
Okay, so... Dang.
All right, cool. We don't have to type that in anymore.
Now, let's go. Now, this is going to be...
Yeah, we're running on time here. I mean, we can run. We still don't have anybody right behind us.
All
right.
Okay. So.
We have cats meow. Oh, dear Lord. Okay.
Control C.
So we did Space Monkey already.
All right, guys. We're doing. Go over. There's some love over on Cats Meow. We're going to do Cats Meow next, which is...
Oh, hold on. Hold on, I got to pull it up again. I'm sorry, I got it all. I've got
See, now she's slacking. What the hell?
But I got to pull it up. It's on mine. We're going to do American... Okay, Kateris are... Use first 20 for 35%. Yes, she did increase that. Thank you. I forgot about that, honey.
Well, I knew that. Well, I was trying to get...
Now, what size...
American Outlaw.
Blue what size? What size is one, sweetie? Is that 30?
What size is Nick and PGVG?
Oh, my battery's down on here. Slow your roll. That's why you're chugging your orange juice, just so you know.
I don't know how you're
trying
to watch
orange
juice,
man.
Oh,
hey. Green with my belly, that's sure.
Yeah, that's what I was going to say. It's a serious ass.
Okay, it's a 30 mil blue zombie, and it's a 70-30 ratio.
Yeah.
I'm glad you're in here, honey. If not, I'd have been messaging you.
What nickels are is it in?
I was going to say, I don't know what the American Outlaw does in theirs. Do they 0, 3, and 6?
I never had American Outlaw, so I don't know.
Zero, 3, and 6. Okay, that's what I figured. About all of them were doing were 0, 3, and 6.
Write that down so we know where to wear it.
Okay. Hold on.
Three, six,
and what is it?
70. 7:30, 30 mil. You missed our other giveaway from our new sponsor, Katara.
You're sleeping in, remember?
Yeah. We got Zombie Z juice. Comes with the tip. In this cool little container with the sticker and a bait band. Yeah. Yay. See what you get for sleeping in? Good shit.
Yeah, he couldn't wait until after we're done doing our interview conversation.
Well, I was trying to bring it up. It was.
Yeah, but you did win one of our ones instead of that way we could actually look at the flavors and the everything with it. You. See, this is what happens when a man doesn't listen. Because if you listen and realize that wouldn't have been the best thing to do. Hey, you're
all right. How many randoms? The first number under 10 is how many randoms we'll do.
And again, this is for American Outlaw Blue Zombie. Is 0, 3, or 6 cool. Nick, 70-30 on the PGBG, and 30 mil bottle is what size we're on. So let's get this done, and let's do, all right, 9, I guess. See, I'm being told, see, this is what happens when you rush it.
The first two said
you
9.
Can't type again. Get off my keyboard.
Then get doing your damn job.
Well, I've got to write things down. And I'm going to beat you on camera.
Now press enter, damn it.
1.
2. 3. 4. 5. 6, 7, 8, 9. Vape Man's in here. Alright, congrats, Daisy. Know what you want. Vape Man's in here. Huh? Vape Man's in here.
Oh.
He is?
I didn't know he was in there. Sit at the library and turn the speakers up real loud so that way when we start.
Are you writing down the word by chance?
Yeah, that's what I've been writing. Thank you.
Good job.
I know that has a desktop. I can't use
one. Ooh. Alright, so then.
Are you writing it down? Are you writing it? You take the freaking script from me, really? Seriously?
Go fill out that form for 70-30 PGG mix. It's pick out your NIC level and for 30 mil of
American Outlaw.
Hey, you're wanting this plug in?
Yeah. It's for American Outlaw.
Blue Zombie.
Yeah, it's a, gosh darn it. It is, you can pick between 0.3 and 6 NIC. It is a 70-30 blend, so you don't have to put the blend on there as far as your PGVG. And that is a 30 mil.
Okay.
Did the last one not have that, Katara? Didn't have the real address? Because I thought on the forms they're supposed to have the real address. I thought it was on there. Because if it didn't,
yeah,
then,
it does.
If it didn't, then maybe that's something we need to look at.
No, it says name, address, city right there.
Okay.
Oh.
Oh, I see. All right, cool. Never mind. Then let me set up it.
Right. Sweet. Well, I'm glad he emailed you back. That's like freaking awesome.
That's...
Ooh, that sounds good. Yeah, that's true. So I mean,
golden cinnamon crust. Ooh, okay. Thanks, Katara, because I want all of their descriptions. If you told me yesterday what it was, I could have got, and I would have.
Right. Okay. So our next. Where the hell are you at? Oh. Damn.
We're going to do our other new sponsor.
Alright, time for our new sponsor, guys.
I know it seems like we're doing a lot of new sponsors, but we're doing a lot of, like, we've done some revamping.
Alright, go show some love. Go check out their website. They've got 300 plus flavors and to create your own and freaking awesome, awesome shit. They are giving away 125 mil every week.
Yep. Ages Faye, they're 125 mils of juice.
And not only that, you can go to their page. They have RDAs, mods, tanks, wicks, wires, all of it. And you put in...
Hold on, he's got to find his notes for it.
He got the damn book.
Well, you should have had your notes all together in another place. You was going to take the book.
And you put, whenever you make an order there for anything, RDAs, mods, tanks, juice, whatever, put in the code CRYPT and you get 35% off your order.
Or beard oil. I don't know, we might go with beard oils. Beer middle sounds like a better way to go. And we may have to, maybe, I don't know. We'll have to, we'll come up with something, Dark.
Right?
Believe me, it's safe.
Trust
not,
me, it ain't nowhere.
We're not done. We're somewhere fighting this.
Yeah. Just like Evan said, that was on the show last week, I'll go to jail before my shit goes to me.
And he won't go to jail. I know he won't. It's a matter of we've got to get everybody together. We're in the process of working on that now.
I've got some few things.
We got people with people who know people who know people.
Anybody want new RDAs, new mods, go check out their website. 35% off of all your orders.
Stop waving it around, so thanks.
But they have, and thing is, not only 300 plus flavors, they are 0 nick, 0.5 nick, 1.5 nick, and then 2 nick all the way up to 36 nick. So they carry every damn nick possible. And another PGV.
We would straight seriously go through their list of flavors for Gothic Vapors, but there is no way.
I'm not even.
Jeff and I had to sit here the other night and we were trying to figure out which ones, you know, sound really awesome to us that we really, really absolutely want to try. Yeah, that was difficult.
I mean, she's not a fruity person, so I've tried some of their fruit stuff. But for us to get our own juice from them, it took us 2 days to figure out what we wanted. That show some good shit, but
I'm sorry. I will brag them. I will brag all about them. I am excited.
Right?
It's awesome. But in order to tell you a really good specific flavor, I don't know everybody's profiles.
Edwin, I know I'm perfect for him. Eddie, I found one perfect for you, bub. It's lime and apple.
Okay, but we don't know everybody's flavor, but that's what I'm getting at. Hi, guys, Ghost Rider.
Hey, bub, I didn't even know you were in here. I'm glad you made it.
But because there is such a drastic selection or array of flavors, we can't specify tell you, hey, no, this one's going to be better than this.
We're not like every other juice. We can't sit there and read the list of flavors and flavor, not lemon, lime. Lime apple.
L-E-M?
L-I-M-E.
I can't spell it out. I've been sitting next to you too long, damn it.
But, one we cannot sit there and read off the names of flavors. Cannot read the pearls. Like I said,
I don't know why it's not telling us who's coming in. Usually I get the alerts.
I know,
for some
right?
reason, it's not giving me that.
But, they got to create your own. They've got 300 plus flavors. You can get from a 20 mil all the way up to, I think, it's 500.
Yeah, Ghost Rider. More than likely it is Bergen. It's
right on the damn.
I know. Ed, this is not some crazy. It's a crazy flavor list. It is
right?
super crazy. They got like anything and everything you can think of. They do not have roast beef. I am so sorry, but they do not have the roast beef, and they do not have the crab legs.
We ain't looking all the sections, so.
No, I don't. They don't have them on there. I did in all the sections. I'm sorry, they don't have meats on. When they offer meats, I will like completely come and let y'all know. I just figured I'd point that out for you.
Well, Eddie, since you're looking at it, a little mind blowing looking at their juice. I'll post the links again, bub. Right there.
Go over, show some love.
Yes.
Check it out.
And I don't know if you're in there when I was talking about it. Any order you make, Ghost Rider, you get 35% off your order
by using
the code CRIPS.
Is that it?
Just Crypt.
See, spell it so that way.
C R Y P T, just like the show. Yeah. Really? He's like, holy
God. They have a heck of a jewel selection. They have they have freaking RDAs and it's crazy.
Yeah, they're like, I mean, this
stop at the top.
Yeah,
everything. Dark Maul, stop with the crab legs, honey. Now I'm gonna have to go some crab legs for lunch.
Yes, I was getting ready to go there too. I was about to bounce that after the giveaway, but yes, right now until today. Use the code Bedlam and Crypt. That'll give you 75% off your orders.
Where at?
Gothic Vapors.
I'm gonna check that out.
That ends today though too.
Oh yeah, I'm really gonna check that out.
So if you don't win, my thing, according to my notifications, it says the 13th.
I probably say it's probably good till midnight tonight, and then it probably stops.
Yeah.
That's what I'm going to guess.
So, but go check them out, and definitely show some love. Okay. This is a giveaway, 125 mil.
Everybody pay attention closely.
Type out the code.
Yes, here.
Yes. C-R...
If he can type the right letters, you'll be good.
Okay. The hell happened to it?
Stop. Hold on. It just froze.
Hello?
Hello?
There we go.
Woo-hoo! We froze. Like, we completely froze.
Okay, you get 35 per... No. If you type in Bedlam...
Different codes to get the 75%.
Okay, Bedlam is 40%.
And then if you combine that with the Crypt,
is 35%.
So you
use Bedlam, you're going to get 75% off your order.
And just so that way you guys are safe, I'd say the Bedlam code is probably... only good till maybe midnight tonight, and maybe good tomorrow. I'm positive.
But ours
is still tomorrow.
Yeah.
So our code.
But our code good every day of the week for 35% off. So 11th to the 14th. Okay. It's okay. For Gothic Vapor, Astorana.
Flip it over until sorry I can do it. It's for that one.
So, go show some love. I'll give you guys minutes. Then we're going to give away 125 mil of juice, which obviously is going to take you some time to
decide. What you want.
Yeah, that's what I thought. About to say, she told me herself, so... that's why reading the message, I thought it was 13. So
we've been having some problems with the web server, the actual host server that we're running on.
I believe
is what we think our major problem is. It does keep freezing. If it does, hit pause, then play.
Yeah.
If you still have too many problems, go out and come back in. Sometimes that helps it. Mm-hmm. That's about the best we can suggest as far as it freezing. We do know that there is a great big lag between what we say and what you guys hear or see on the video. It's completely off. Completely.
Does YouTube do that too, or is it in sync on YouTube?
Mm-mm. I don't know. I don't think so.
Okay.
Know.
Like I said, go show some love.
Last night, so. All right, so we did that one. What do we decide we want to do for like items on theirs? Random, or are we gonna do numbers on theirs?
Numbers.
You think we should do numbers?
Actually, you know what?
25 mil.
He's right. Let's switch it up a little. We're not doing random. We're going to do numbers.
And Cody's going to pick the number. Jeff, Cody's going to pick the number. So that way, no!
You put for the host death drips.
Okay.
On Vape in the Crypt.
So, okay, so what do we want to pick
for? What do I write down? Host death drips?
No, not you.
No, answer. Just pick the number.
We're going to pick a number from between
one and.
How many people are in the room?
We have 24.
23,
24.
Okay, so
between
1 and
50. Codes didn't do anything. I know the crypt works. I just used it yesterday.
We can do 1 through, what, 20?
1 through 30.
Want
to
do
1
through
30?
So write a big number in.
Okay.
Hold on. You're going to write down a number between 1 and
Hold 30. On. Before you start, he's got to write it down. You got to type it in right first.
Sure, bro.
I'm going to be completely random. I'm just going to type in the number and fall out looking at it and do the number.
All right. So you are going to pick a number between and spell.
Okay.
Between 1 and 30. And. What is the thing for you? This?
Me.
Like this?
And
like that?
Yep.
And there we go. 1 through 30. Closest number without going over, right? Is what we're going to do?
It can be over or under the closest one, so. All right,
I got you. That's fine. Oh,
that moment.
I know, right? Get your numbers in. Don't even.
I used a random number on my keypad, too.
So, here, give me something right now. Give me that paper.
Hold on.
Now I want to write something down while I'm thinking about it. What did you do with my pen?
You're welcome, guys.
Thanks, man. I was going to write it on there.
Ooh. Okay. Alright.
Because we're going to have to do,
I'll do
move papers.
Okay, I'm doing the countdown. You better get your numbers in. No, you can't put more than two numbers in, so.
One number.
Nine.
So, Slipknot, decide which one are you using?
No, first number.
First number is who we're going to stick with?
Yeah, that's...
And you're... I'm not even
21? Going. Okay.
So, Slipknot going with 21.
4, 3, 2, 1.
You can't type because 9 is not how it comes after 1.
0. All right.
So, then...
Hold on. It would be King. The number is... Team.
I feel so bad now.
Number 19. So
and
we have.
That so sucks, Slipknot.
I feel bad now.
Damn.
So that would be.
This one.
Yep. King Arthur. Or Arthur.
Whatever. I see. So. He showed us the number right as everybody started to put their things in. I was like, oh, Lord. Right. And you guys did already. This is going to be interesting.
It's that moment where Slipknot is kicking himself into the ass.
Right?
Saying, I should have went with that first fucking number.
Yeah, because then we would have done some kind
Grats, of... Grats, King. Late birthday present. There you go. 125 mil. So, go to their website. I will post it again.
It's going to take you a minute.
It's going to take a minute to,
Just so you know, it will take you a minute to find your flavor.
Okay. Go to their website and pick you out whatever flavor, flavor, Nick, all that, PGG. Get it picked out, fill out on the form. And send it to that and
form.
Submit your form and
we'll get it. Your show is Vape in the Crypt. Your host is Death Drips.
And drips they have for some reason on the Wonders Forum, spelled with two P's. I know, it's wrong.
Many name the word for King it.
It's the freaking mother load.
Yeah, it's
like I said, it took us days to just pick out three flavors of pizza.
It's freaking crazy.
Yeah, I asked a little bit when he.
Oh, yeah, he's here on the
walking
into Toys R Us with all the money in the world.
It's right. It's going to take you more than a minute. Yeah, you know, it's going to take you a few minutes. Unless you like already got from them and you kind of already know what you like from them. Yeah, it's going to take you a minute.
What I would do, or King, open up a new tab with the winner's form. So have a tab for the website, a tab for the winner's form. It's not letting you? Oh, the other one only for juices. Okay, ours will, I forgot. Yeah, it's only for juices, so.
Oh,
but you can get I forgot it was only for juices. Ours is for anything in the store, so. You can still get 35% off an RDA. But, yeah, definitely make sure you have a separate tab. That way you've already got the winner form and the website up. So you can just bounce back and forth as you fill it out.
Sorry, Estrana. That's what Jeff gets for being in a rush.
So.
Some coupons cannot be combined with other coupons. Have you never read that on a coupon?
Well, you can, but. You can't use it all on the RDA. You can use 75% off on the juice. But only ours is good for in there, not just juice.
Ours is good for everything, not just juice?
Yeah. Sure. Yeah, 35% off. The code for 35% on ours is CRYPT. CRYPT.
So the other one is just for juice.
Yeah, the other one's just for juice. I did read it. I forgot all about it, though. Even 35% off on an RDA.
I didn't look at their prices on their RDAs. I kind of feel bad.
Well, I already found one.
By the way, you realize you're 10 minutes over, and how many more do we have?
I mean, we can skip DDB this week, I guess.
We can. I think we're just about everybody in the room has some.
Well, I don't know. We got a few new ones, though. Oh, no problem. It didn't work for the RDA. Hold on.
Crypt didn't?
Something's not right here.
You may have to get a hold of her, then.
Okay, I'm going to have to get a hold of her, it looks like.
Get it figured out what the deal is. We don't have the drip in yet. We haven't got those in yet. Stop it. You didn't get it until like 9 o'clock today. Holy crap.
And just so you... Edwin, if you go to...
We actually have about 9 or 10.
It's been nice.
What the fuck? Come on.
That's why you have too many tabs. Close some tabs. How many open?
Okay. If you go to... Maybe...
We got to see the crypt to get the 35% off our juice.
If you go to the fruit flavors...
What are you...
Everyone asked where to get that lime.
Please just show me. Even got some. Oh. We even ordered some bitter bitch.
Yeah, I heard about that.
It's supposed to be a palate reset.
Yeah, we was talking about it. Alright, so
the flavoring reset.
Okay, what page was that on?
Sprite seems to work.
Sprite.
Right, yeah. That little Sprite, the knockoff rat.
It has to be true.
That's right.
Okay.
I'm trying to use the size.
I went to a standard post, all I would do is 0 1 time.
I'm going up.
I just straightened my next.
Jeff just straight went like this and like jammed it right through. And I'm like, ah!
Page 8 of the fruits, about halfway down. Oh, then it looks like you're, it's 125 mil, King. Page 8, halfway down, it's called Shockwave. That's the lime out. And I am checking on the code now.
I'm hurting because I slept in these instead of sleeping in my actual table. You realize we're still on a show?
Oh, I'm trying to get this figured out.
So you got him all distracted doing this and I can't. So that way we can get this all figured out. What are you doing anyway? What are you trying to do? See why it's not there?
Oh, shit.
Do, do, do. Flip over to the. I don't have. Oh, wait. Do I have a slip? I feel like I came, like, out in space and nowhere because I can't see anybody or hear anybody.
That's nothing new.
Shut your mouth. Hey, I'm still in the room. Okay, I'm back. To try spiced pumpkin pie. They have so many. It's not even funny.
Why is it not working?
Do it?
Yeah, it didn't work. Okay. Spiced pumpkin pie.
That's what I just told you. So this is what happens when he doesn't listen.
How the hell are you out of DDB, Edwin? You've ordered, he's ordered so much damn juice, he should be nowhere near Al.
Son, you should have enough left in one or two of those skulls. I think you've got, a total of two or three of them skulls?
Yeah, you've got at least two or three of them skulls. Oh.
Hey, newsflash, we don't do skulls anymore.
Right? I don't think it'll be all caps.
You're going to make him jump back and forth.
There's our purple bottles, our 475 mils. Then our 60 mils.
Back up from your camera so you can see them. Seriously, again, you gotta go pee?
No. My tummy gurgles.
No more Chinese for you!
Thanks, because I drank a fucking gallon of orange juice.
You're gonna drink water. That's it! Jeff has to drink water.
Oh, don't even get me started, dog. I went to reorder your damn skulls. Put it this way. I can now only order two skulls.
So on yours, we're going to have to do two skulls. The rest are going to be the big purple bottles.
Yeah.
And so, that is... Man,
I am so pissed off.
We had so many problems. It's ridiculous.
I mean, I'm not a happy camper, so, if you want to sell the big ones, we can do that, too, so, and I'll, Dark Malt already knows USPS is on my hit list. I'm not too happy with them right now.
A lot of reason why I switched to plastic.
I know, right?
And considering, honey, we are going to
plastic.
Or the plastic. So when you get the 30 mils that you have
gone,
gone, sold.
You need to change your prices because it's going 60 mil.
Vegas is going up on them, and we're going over to 60 mils.
So. Oh, you're good on DDB. You about to say, I know your ass can't be out of DDB. Yeah, no problems. Anytime, Dandy, so. But, yeah, I mean, if you want to carry big bottles on the site, too, let us know.
Katara, hook up with us later, honey, in chat, and we'll discuss it if you want to change anything up or add. If you want to do that, that's awesome.
I'm pretty sure he's getting them the same as I am, but they're out on them. They only have two left, so...
We have gone through, I can't tell you how many different...
How many places we've gone through to get them damn skulls, and every time it's a freaking joke.
Either it takes us like a month, 2 months to get them, ordering them, or all of a sudden at the last minute, oh, hey, we don't have those anymore. Yeah. Can you order something else? No, because I need that for an order.
That's the same people.
Oh my god, we just seriously got that orange juice this morning.
Oh, I put through an entire bottle of Sprite in cars.
Holy crap, out loud. Well, I guess I could go through a freaking scene. I bet you he didn't think about that.
I'm in trouble.
Hold on, he's checking now.
What are you looking for?
The look on his face, you just seen it was so hilarious. He tried to put it in, and he, like, totally looked up and be like, oops, that's not going to work.
It'll sit on the edge of the holes. It won't fit in holes.
So keep your 30 mil bottles, and you can just refill your 30 mil bottles. That way you can keep them displayed. See, I've got you.
Well, the only thing I can think is we're going to have to get new racks. I don't have to, but...
No, because we've got enough juice from everywhere else that we don't really need any more.
Or take a Dremel and make the hole bigger.
That's an idea.
Couldn't be that hard.
What happened?
It don't fit.
Our new bottles don't fit in the rack.
The 60 mils don't fit in our rack.
And he bought one of the racks and it won't fit.
Yeah, the
60 mils. Just need a new tray. Well, there you go. Have one for a collector item and one for to hold your juice.
I'd like to I have an idea as far as those trays go.
Oh, that's why the lights are flashing.
No, I do. I do have a really, really good idea for those trays, Ed, and I think you'll like the idea that I have. So. Yes. If you want to do it that way.
Fit in what tray?
They fit. You know what they fit in? They fit not even perfectly in your hand, but you can get your hand around them for the most part. But they don't fit in the tray either. No.
Yeah, that.
By far, will they fit in that tray? They'll fit in your cup holder in your car.
I don't recommend you carry that in your pocket.
You're offering to carry this in your pocket?
No, I said I don't recommend.
I would. It's definitely a fill while you're at home and
All right. Just because. All right, guys. We'll do the last one for today because there's been a few that said they ain't got them.
Your dad can't shut up.
All right. Go like our page. Go like our page, our group. Go like Gothic Vaping. We'll do a giveaway for 60 mil DDV and Gothic Vaping drip tip.
But not for long, sweetheart. Not for long. Not for long. You've got some demon spit coming.
Val say she won, so.
We're gonna get you fixed up. We're gonna get you hooked. Right.
Air of anguish.
We have a reverb. That isn't surprising me in the slightest that there's a reverb going on.
So go show some love on all those pages. Let's do a giveaway for 60 mil of DDB and a drip tip.
I'm not good at describing what a reverb is per se. It's kind of like when it sounds like you're stuttering type of effect.
Kind of like when she talks when she's a...
Okay, here you do.
Did I stutter?
That'd be you. That's why everybody loves coming in here. You realize that, right? It's because they love the fact that I sit here and I can beat you up on TV. And no, I'm kidding. Quit!
You're in well, the way y'all from Maryland win fucking every damn giveaway, no wonder y'all in jail.
I think that we ought to have a line up when you enter the room that says Maryland is now off limits for DDB. You are all in jail for the time being. We will see you in 30 days. Come and enjoy the show, but you can't win. We love you, though.
But the bad thing is, we love you. Even on JVs, they're all in jail for DDB.
I know, what the heck is up? You guys, that's like serious. You guys are like in jail with DDB for both shows.
Right?
It's because you love the villains. That's what it is.
No, they love the DDB. That's why.
No, it's because they...
You're hiding now.
Is that why everybody else is hiding? That's why nobody's here today from Maryland, except for the two of them.
They can win,
but that's a good point. If I didn't name it, if it wasn't already named, it might not be a bad thing to say or do.
Actually, you can win on this show.
Because it's a different show.
It's a different show.
Then you just be in it on both shows.
Then you'll be in, join the Maryland crew in jail, so. Eddie, you don't even need to be in DDB jail. You got so much damn juice in your house.
You won the whole line of Suicide Bunny?
Cool.
Wow. Okay, yeah. Now I that's it. We gotta go up and I've gotta like do some like juju rubs or something.
Go start buying me a lottery ticket.
I know, right? I'm going to PayPal you some money. Can you buy me some lottery tickets and scratch
right?
for me and let me know what I won?
But you all have to go as a crew.
Yeah,
all of you.
It's like a, you know, like a, it's like a Buddha thing. You gotta rub each other's bellies or something. There's gotta be something there.
Yeah, we're only like an hour apart, so. But yes, you're not in jail here because you haven't won here. So you could still win some.
Sharing is caring.
You could still win 60 mil juice today.
Some more demon spit for you.
Yep.
And there are some other ones. I didn't go into it last night because I figured you were tired. Yes, Indiana Ghost Rider.
Yeah,
all
Ghost
the way,
Rider's
baby.
He's the one that added us to that other Indiana.
I know that. I don't know why you think I'm retarded.
Well, that is you.
Oh, and I'm going to punch you. Cody, close your eyes. You two close your eyes. I'm going to punch him off his chair. Everybody online, don't watch. No, I'm kidding. We need to talk to the camera
guys. First question. How many DV virgins we got in here?
Me. I'm kidding. Cody said he is.
Me. I am.
I just say what I want.
Slept hard. You're a retard.
I went in on her, under me and I said me.
All right. Just for that case, we're doing two giveaways.
We're going to do two?
Yeah, I called bullshit on her too.
No, it's no, that wasn't me. I swear it wasn't me. Cody, stay off of my thing, man.
Wow, way to pass the blame.
It was one of the kids. It was the dog. The dog did it.
Speaking of that, where is the damn dog?
The dog's in the crate because Cody came over. She started barking at him.
Let her out.
You let her out. She's fine.
So, first giveaway for all the virgins. Let's see. We got 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. 1. We're going to do numbers for the, oh no, we'll do randoms for the virgins too.
Alright, well, how are you going to do randoms for them? Are you going to do just for them?
Yeah, that's not a good idea.
Okay, so figure out who they are and have them pick numbers. Just that group, and then we'll do randoms
for the others. This is just for the... Just the virgins. Put in a number.
DDV virgins. Let me rephrase this.
DDV virgins, put in a number 1 to 15. Hey, yes, nice try.
Baby. Yeah.
Look at him trying to slide in there. Astrona, you don't count either.
I like Aegis Fate. I like his number. I'm good with it. I am so good with it. Oh, hey, Cody, where are you?
What?
Yeah, where's that paper he had earlier? Did you wad it up so he could use it again? Give him the pen. He can't have my pen. You have to give him a different pen. Give him that pen.
Okay, hold on. I thought he already wrote the damn number down.
Way to go.
All right.
Save your cup. Yes, save the other
thing. Let's start it again. 1 through 15 for the DDV virgins.
Oh, for kind of loud, son.
1 through 15.
Yeah.
1 through 15. And hold on just a minute.
Hold on. Yeah, I know. Come on, Cody. He's starting to act like her. Slacking.
I got this. Here we go.
No, turn around when you write it. There's a reason why I say that. Turn around when you write it. I'll explain it later.
Hold on. I didn't put start yet.
Really hard.
Now, put your numbers in.
He's doodling smiley faces, I think, on the page
now.
Oh,
good Lord.
See, I gave him a different pen, and he can't write with that pen. He don't know how to draw.
Wait, hold up. Oh, here's the
stuff. Okay. Wherever your kids are ready.
Seriously?
I did doodle smiley face, by the way.
Okay.
Isn't it, though? That's not your standard smiley.
Stop. And the winner is... Number 12. Who do we have?
Looks like...
It'd be Dandy. Congrats, Dandy.
Oh, my God. I'm not even... I didn't open that.
What?
I don't even open that. Who's that face?
See.
Just do that like secret read where you slide it down.
All right, Dandy.
Yeah, you like go back to your main thing.
Okay, hold on. So if I take this and go away, shit, dinner.
But just fucking see what the hell she wants.
I was gonna say is if you want to like secretly read something, you just pull it down in here. And usually.
You want a 60 mil and a drip tip.
That's how I can read messages and never reply to them.
Our drip tips will be in tomorrow, so then you can pick the caller. So just put drip tip, and when I send it out. But, Pooh, don't give up. I'm getting ready to do a giveaway for everybody. So now... Now you're joining the Maryland crew, Dandy. You're in jail now, so. Yeah, do. Babe, read off the flavor list. Yes, you get to pick a flavor.
I'm sorry,
and a
I'm
nick
talking
level.
To two different freaking, I've got people hitting me up. What are we doing?
Read off flavor.
Where
list.
Are you going? Seriously? Alright, hold on, because, like, I gotta find it. And I've got, like, all kinds of... I've got weird people messaging me that I haven't talked to in a long time. Okay, so, Death Grips Vapors. That's what we're doing? Is that the one I'm reading? Okay, sorry. Don't get crappy with me. That's funny. So our flavors are Pear of Anguish, which is, hold on, I cannot read these cards whatsoever. Pear, Watermelon, Lime, and Gummy Candy. Demonic Temptation. Demonic Temptation is Mango, Dragon Fruit, Pineapple, and Vanilla Custard. Sorry, I have to read this. I work so much, I don't get this stuff memorized very well. Leprechaun's Blood is Skittles Candy. That literally tastes like a Skittles candy. Cody loves those. Do you like, that's your favorite one, isn't it? Leprechaun's Blood? Or is it Pear?
I have a mixture between the Leprechaun's Blood and the Pear of Anguish. Right now, my all-day vape is that Pear of Anguish. It is really good. I would love to do that jellyfish. God, I don't know if I can get one. Maybe I can get one into the camera.
I'm trying to think if you, to get it into the camera good. Hey, let me read the rest of these real quick, and we'll see where we can put you. Devil's Delight is Scotch, Vanilla Custard, Sweet Cream, and Marshmallow. Lost Souls, Candy Pineapple, and Strawberry. Demon Spit is Lime, Orange, and Grapefruit. That's the reason why it's great. Demented Ghost is Beetlejuice flavor. It is mixed berries is what it is. That's the best way to describe that one. It's berries. Crypt Keeper is orange, sweet cream, marshmallow, and vanilla custard. Did it even get in the frame? It sort of got in that camera. Fallen Angel is cotton candy and cream soda. And Devil's Lust is what? Oh, there it is. Mango. Stop. Mango, lime, keep going. Mango, dragon fruit, pineapple, lime, peach, and vanilla custard. Sorry, that one I do not know. He did that one while I wasn't even home, and he hasn't even got it added to the list, so that's number 10. It's the newest flavor we've got. Let me see here. Let me pull up that camera so that way you can see it a little better and what is going on. Okay, Cody's trying to do a jellyfish. Do you see where this is coming? Where the camera's angle? There you go. See?
It didn't move. I didn't go forward like it should have.
You're too tall. Here. Bump it up. Does it work if I bump it up?
Yeah,
do you see where I'm at? So, since you're so tall?
Yeah, right here.
Okay, he's going to try and do a jellyfish, everybody. No pressure.
It's about getting one in the tiny area.
No pressure, Cody. No pressure, man.
I love you love me.
I can't get one in this tiny little area here. I don't know if you can see it. Well, back there.
I'm honest. Modesty is my policy.
Straight into the camera.
I know, right? Move over a little. See, she's telling you how to do it. See, because I've got you on this one is the one you can actually see here. There's no lag in this one.
Yeah, it's too small of an area.
Yeah, the area's too small. Man, we're trying, Astrana. He is, like, killing himself. I don't know if you could do it from walking from back there up here. From this camera.
I might be able to shoot it across the screen.
You might be able to.
I hope you can't. Can you
see? I can see your toes. Jasmine, put your foot down. You're going to have to come down a little bit because that camera, I cannot tip. Maybe. Oh, wait, hey, there.
Or is that at the corner of the room?
Do you see where I'm at?
Okay. Try to see if I can get you a little bit. They're so hard to see.
You can kind of see them. It's doing good when I actually get up real far. Oh, let's try to catch it. I was chasing it with the camera. Okay. I like totally. I've gotten that wrong. Ah! Okay. Hold on just a moment. Miss Thing, you can't sit there. You gotta move over. Question. Yeah, well, I don't know what I did, but when I moved the camera, it like totally put you right back in this picture.
Stay there. No, don't move.
It's like all the way down here. Maybe I can shoot one across that.
Well, do you want me to tilt it back up? I can tilt it back up again. She saw it.
Oh, did she?
Okay.
All right. There is a video getting ready to come up with me and Jake, the other on Death Trips. We do have a collabo that's, if you guys are on Instagram, we're getting ready to have a collabo video come, and there's going to be all kinds of jellyfishes on there and just a ton of vape tricks between the two of us. So, you know, that will be there, and I'll give these guys the direct link for that when that does get posted. It'll be one of just him, one of just me, and then one of both of us together, just between the two of us. And we'll also have full videos that will be posted to Facebook. And again, I will tag these guys in it and give them a link to that as well. And the rest is these guys.
All right.
Thank you for moving, by the way, sis. But he was, I could see her. I kept seeing her in the background. I was like, you need to move. You need to move.
But, okay. Yeah, Jake should have that up Tuesday by the latest.
Okay, so then we'll be able to share it.
We got 40 minutes of video we got to push through here, and most of it's us just guessing and finding the right music to vape to. Me nicking out.
Oh, jeez.
Burning up my tank. There was a lot.
One.
Because we got to try to pull 15 seconds in 40 minutes. So.
Three. Four. Five. Six. 7, 8
Didn't say anything.
9, 10, 11, 12, 13 Daisy. Woohoo! Jumped the gun there.
Do you know what you've won?
We did send you a sample of the new one, didn't we, Katara?
Are you fucking joking me?
What?
For the shirts. That's who's doing those shirts. I don't want
one. Oh, no.
Like, how I can feel your pain. It was right here.
Yeah, I don't want one. I'm not supporting her.
Nope.
Yeah, I'm not. Sorry, but I won't.
Yeah, that was the unlabeled one. Copy.
You just let yourself in. Draft over here, kid.
We had two different ones win on Amber. We had Daisy 33 just win that one.
Oh yeah, I haven't wrote those down, by the way.
And then we had Dandy 1017 won the DDV version.
Okay, so who won one? I'm like completely.
Dandy won DDV in a drip tip, and Daisy 33 won drip tip and.
Oh, so you did two drip tips, just the DDV. Okay.
Oh, she won. She didn't already win today on our show.
Who, Daisy?
Yeah. My Duff Cam Oh. She won Kateras.
Yes, sorry.
Oh. Okay, sorry.
I've seriously got some issues going on with something else that is not related to the show, and it's after showtime, technically, so I'm trying to deal with it, too. Sorry, guys. I can't do both, obviously, at the same time.
Okay, so, with that being said...
Sorry about that, Daisy. We did not realize one, that.
Two, three, 50. Four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13.
Is he even in there? Are you even in the room, sweetheart? Because I don't know if you're in the room.
I don't think he's in here.
I thought he was at a show today.
Yeah.
Not in the room.
He says he's going to try hopping on his phone, but I haven't seen him.
Crispy.
Damn, Astrona.
Damn, girl.
You can't win the DDB, so you try to get pissed.
Yeah, I got some problems.
Okay.
Okay, so...
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13.
Seriously?
Seriously.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. Has he won?
He won Space Monkey today.
Are you in jail, Eden? I don't remember. We're looking at the book.
No, Ed won one element last.
Then he won Space Monkey today.
Yep, he did win it. No, I wasn't thinking about that. Oh, good Lord.
What were you doing? 13? Let's do 6 this time.
Yeah,
we're going to shorten this. We're going to do 6 randoms this time and see if maybe we get something different.
Yeah, we're changing our lucky number, obviously.
Today for right now. So 1.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, there's 6.
Pick me in. There you go. You got it, sweetheart. Do you know what you won?
And Gothic vaping drip tip too. Yeah, Gothic vaping drip tip. That's my red one.
We need to get off air. We need to get off air. We've been on air for almost 3 hours.
All right. Make sure you come join us in Vaping the Crypt. We have our own page. Definitely come over there. Post your wins. We like to see your wins. Come hang out with us in Vaping the Crypt all week long in the group. So.
There's also the shows are on tonight. Just a minute.
We'll go through the week's list.
Let's start with Sunday today.
Is our show from 2 to 4. Obviously, we went over today some guests, so we kind of went a little over. From 8 p.m. to 10 p.m. tonight, Nacho Bel Grande with Kick-Ass Chris and Blue Phoenix. From 10 p.m. to 12 a.m., Villainous Vapecation. I'm not sure who all is going to be on at host tonight. We will find that out as it comes around. On Mondays, from 10 p.m. to 12 a.m. is Voltage Drop with Puffy. Then on Tuesdays, we have from 10 p.m. to 12 a.m., Y'all Ready for Bliss with Dysfunctional and Blinker. On Wednesdays, from 8 p.m. to 10 p.m., is Sons of Vapors with Chris and Tara Thomas. From 10 p.m. to 12 a.m. is Kicking the Clouds Up with T.R. Cottrell and Twisted Chris. That'd be Tara and Chris Cottrell. Tara and Chris won. on Thursdays, it's 1 to 3 p.m. Villainous Lunch Break with J.V. Rashi and Varied Host. From 11 p.m. to 1 a.m. on Thursday is Bring the Madness with Surreal Vapes and Spider One. Fridays from 10 p.m. to 12 a.m. is the Slumber Party with either the Villainettes or it's Guys Night Out with the Men of Villainous. So, we got Saturday. There's one more day. 7 days in the week. Woo! All right, Saturday from 8 p.m. to 10 p.m. is Vape Rattle and Roll with J.B. Rashi again. 10 p.m. to 12 a.m. is Live Long and Vape On with Josh Dillard and Vaping Cringer. So, guys, feel free to come back and check out the shows tonight that are on. We got Nacho Grande and Vapecation coming on tonight. So, look forward to seeing you guys all back next Sunday, at least, from 2 to 4. Thank you very much, Rihanna. We love you guys. We love you guys. We love all of you. Next time, bring friends. Yes. Bring friends. We love friends.
Tell you what, the first show we can get 40 viewers, we're going to do a 475 mil giveaway.
I want to do 50.
Okay. 50. We get the first show we get 50 viewers in here, we're doing a 475 mil giveaway.
So we get some people up in here. Let's go build up Vape of the Crypt up on Facebook. And we get 50 viewers or more up in here doing watching the show on Sundays.
Yes, no jail.
475 mil bottle of DDV, baby.
And it ain't going to be anybody in jail for that one. Everybody's available for the 475 mil.
Yep. That will not be a jail day.
So y'all will get pardons on that show.
All right.
Later, guys. Catch you next Sunday. Definitely coming out with us and Vaping the Crypt on Facebook. I'll give you guys the link for help.
What'd you do? Get rid of the links. Oh, who won the other DVD? The DDP? I had to, like, totally...
Katara and...
Yeah. Okay, you can't chase and you can't have orange juice no more. Click on it, it's not chilling very well with you.
Alright, there you guys go. Come join groups going on. Start sharing. Let's get people up in here and have some hella giveaways.
Hey, great show. Thanks, everybody, for coming over. Thank you for the help with the questions. It was awesome. Thank you, guys.
All right.
You guys have a wonderful, wonderful day.
All right. Later.
We done up these? Okay. We're not done up these. You made me look retarded. Just saying.
Well, I don't take much to do, but...
Are we off camera?